I would like to present our study about the improvement in functional capacity on a transfemoral amputee after a keep walking end-implant with a distal support. Lower limb amputation is a definitive surgical procedure and has an important functional, psychological and social sequelae that affect the quality of life of the person involved. Two levels of amputation have been described in femoral patients: transfemoral amputation and knee disarticulation. Preservation of the femoral condyles in patients with knee disarticulation allows a distal support into the socket in contrast to what happened in transfemoral amputation. The distal support of the residual limb into the socket increases the control of the prosthesis and increase in independence for walking and lower energy consumption compared to transfemoral amputation. The ability to walk with a prosthesis is the main objective of rehabilitation following an amputation, and the distance and speed of walking achieved is considered a determining factor in amputees' perception of quality of life. The advantage of knee disarticulation compared with transfemoral amputation have led to the design of an intramedullary implant with a distal spacer that allows a direct load of the residuum on the distal surface of the socket and mimics the function on the femoral condyle. We have developed the femoral implant in three phases: design of the implant, biomechanical trials of the implant, and surgical technique validation. The implant is made of three pairs. The femoral stem is made of a titanium alloy to facilitate the anchorage into the residual femoral canal. The length of the femoral stem ranges from 110 to 180 mm with a diameter of 11 to 17 mm. The second part is a spacer made of high density polyethylene with three sizes: large, medium and small. The third part is a titanium screw inside and a polyethylene plug which closes the spacer. The surgery is a quick and easy intervention. It's necessary to reopen the residuum and cut away about 3 cm of the residual femur. The intramedullary cavity must be regularized in order to place the femoral implant. Then, the femoral implant is introduced into the bone and the residuum is closed without excessive tension of the tender tissues. A post-surgical radiological control is needed to be sure of the adequate placing of the implant. The purpose of the study was to evaluate the increase in functional capacity due to an implant that allows distal load of the femoral residuum. An experimental before and after intervention study has been done in a group of 29 transfemoral patients who received a titanium implant allowing distal weight bearing of the residuum within the socket. Participants were recruited from the 1st of March 2011 to the 1st of March 2014 in a multicentric study carried out in 5 hospitals in Spain. This study was approved by the Ethical Committee. The inclusion criteria were: in home or community gait, prosthesis users for at least 12 months, residual femoral length for great trochanter for at least 50 cm, and unilateral transfemoral amputation. The criteria for exclusion were the presence of cognitive impairment, body weight over 100 kg, active oncologic pathologies, psychological disorder, previous residual infection or active infection. All the surgeries were performed by the same surgical team, maintaining the same prosthetic knees and feet used previously. Each patient underwent the pre- and post-operative control, and the follow-up period was 14 months. The main measure of the study was to evaluate the increase in distance and walking speed in the test 2-minute walking test. The secondary measures were to lower pain, improve the bone mineral density, socket use, and oxygen consumption. The rehabilitation program began 1 week after the surgery. Between 4 and 6 weeks after the surgery, we made the provisional socket with the distal load, and then the amputee began the gait training. Around 3 months later, we can make the final socket. In this picture, we can see the provisional socket. And in this one, in the right side, you can see the final socket about 3 months later after the surgery. The initial sample of the study were 29 patients. 5 of them, they were required a removal of the implant, 3 for secondary infection of the residuum, and 2 for another medical reason. The final sample of the study were 23 patients. The average age was 51 years old, 18 males and 5 females. Almost 50% of the patients had comorbidities like diabetes, cardiopathy, or respiratory disease. The etiology of the amputation was traumatic in 11 patients, dysvascular in 9, and femoral in 3 patients more. The daily prosthetic use was 10.7 hours a day. The distance improved from 103.6 to 128 meters. The gait speed improved from 0.86 to 1.06 meters per second. The base scale improved from 2.7 to 0.3. The socket use improved from 10.7 to 12.8 hours, and the oxygen consumption improved from 18.3 to 20. All these results were statistically significant. Finally, the bone mineral density of the femoral knee improved from 0.612 to 0.674, not being statistically significant. The adverse events during the clinical trial were 5, 1 bone fissure during the surgery, 3 screw loosening, and 1 seroma. We can conclude that a femoral implant that allows a direct load of the residuum improve functional capacity, gait speed and distance, pain, and time of use of prosthesis in transfemoral. Thank you very much.